Boys. Alright, so I'm gonna try to find some good lighting real quick. Alright, well, yeah, so it's actually the day after the recording. I tried to record stuff in the car, but I guess I didn't have the microphone on, so I'm getting real good at this YouTube game. Clearly, it's not getting easier for me, but about to go smash a back workout. Although you won't see it, you're gonna see a leg workout that I hit yesterday. But we're sipping on some straight nectar. Berserk Haterade flavored pre-workout. I like went into that yesterday a little bit. Yeah, so check it out. Gonna hit a sick leg day. You're gonna see that. It was gross. Tons of pain. My legs are so sore right now. So, you know, that's always a good thing. And then I was gonna, oh my gosh, forgive me in advance. Actually, no, you'll forgive me later. But yeah, check out this sweet leg day. If you're feeling up for it, try it out during your next session. It's miserable. So I'll see you guys after you see the leg day. Peace.
Hey guys, welcome to Leg Day ASMR featuring Luke. So today I'm going to explain to you each of the workouts that I did during this leg day to destroy my quads. So as you can see here, we're starting off pre-exhausting our quads with the leg extension at the beginning of this leg day. I'm holding the weight at the top of the movement for like 20 to 30 seconds, and I'm trying to literally stick my toes into the ceiling as hard as you possibly can. It will just melt your legs right off the bat, and then we finish off doing the reps with the weight after holding it for 20 to 30 seconds, so your legs are already torched completely, and then you have to perform reps with this weight afterwards. Really focusing at the squeeze at the top of the movement. I'm really focusing on time under tension today. I incorporate days like this into my program every now and again to really switch things up. And as you can see, I'm only doing like 70 pounds, but literally just however long this was under tension for, it just destroys your legs. So that was our final set of leg extensions. Then we went on to the leg press. And the same thing applies here. We held the weight for 20 to 30 seconds at 90 degrees. And this just absolutely roasts your legs. You can see here a little bit. I'm like vibrating right now because it was so brutal. Well, this is our last set too, or last like working set for this style with the leg press. You'll see what I mean in a second. But yeah, you might also observe that I'm chewing on a cloth, and that's because I tend to eat my sweatshirts when I do these kind of leg days, just because it hurts a lot, so I need to like bite on something. And I didn't bring any gum, so I might be a little weird, but hey, don't knock it till you try it. So we did 20 reps following the 20 to 30 second hold, which was brutal. And then after this, we go on to the leg press finisher, and I thought I was an absolute sicko and could do this without music, but that was not the case whatsoever, so I had to plop the headphones back on the head. Most likely listening to some Billie Eilish, maybe some Fergie. Really get the legs fired up. But yeah, so what we're doing here is we're doing a drop set with every single plate. So you're supposed to perform 20 reps with each plate, and then after you do 20 reps, you hold the weight at the top and remove a plate from either side, and then do 20 more reps until there's one plate left on each side. So if you have some boys here like I did, they can remove the weights for you so you don't have to get up and attempt to stand after your legs are filled up with tons of blood. So that's what happened there. You might notice that all the workouts that we're doing on this day are really quad focused, and that's just because I like to split up my leg days into 2 days, one quad focused and one hamstring focused. So all the exercises we're doing are quad focused today. That's just what works better for me. Some people that might not be the case, but you might want to give it a shot if you're not seeing any leg gains. So there you go. So yeah, I'm just grinding out these reps here. Tons of pain right there. As you can see, I'm sweaty as can be. Check that out. Yeah, so the camera actually got filled up there. But the gentleman that was recording was kind enough to delete some old footage so that we could make room for this last exercise. So what we're doing here is heavy barbell squats in this nice free weight-ish Smith machine with our heels elevated. That way we're really focusing on our teardrop muscle and our quads. The heels elevated makes it a slightly more difficult, so you can't really do as much weight. However, you can go into very far depth, like you can damn near sit on your ankles like that. At least I can, so it's easier to focus on my quads. We don't do a lot of reps here, just heavy weight, finish off the legs, and yeah, this was our last exercise.
Yes, sir. Post 30 minutes on the stairs, post leg day. Brutal. Mark's dying. He's got no kind of cardiovascular endurance. So it's brutal. Little physique update, I suppose. One sec. From dusk till dawn, I'll make my way. I'll make my way. Before I'm gone, I'll make my way. I'll make my way. Give me your tears, I will make fire from them. Give me your power, I will make gods of them. Give me your wish, I will make truth of it. Give me your chance, and I'll do all of it. Yeah, so that's how we're looking. 3 days ago when I got home, or before I left for Illinois, I was 166. I've had a lot of carbs the past few days, so I'm probably back up to like 170 at least. Oh man, I'm feeling great. Putting calories back into the diet's making me feel real good. Stay tuned. I'm about to come out with my lean bulking program, how I'm gonna come out with that in the future. It's gonna be sweet. I'm feeling great after that lift. Hope you like the physique update also. If you're a stim head and you like getting cracked out going to the gym, this pre-workout is amazing. Literally one of the best lifts I've had in a while. That pre-workout kicks ass. I loved it. Yeah, so stay tuned. I'm gonna bring you guys along to this epic cheat meal me and Mark are about to go to. So yeah, I'll see you there. I'm gonna go home and get showered up. It's me, dope. Peace. Welcome back to my kitchen. Yeah, so you're probably thinking to yourself, Luke, where the hell is this awesome cheat meal you were telling us all about? And I'm gonna be honest, I totally forgot to bring the camera into the cheat meal vicinity, and I didn't want to downgrade to a prehistoric iPhone 8 and try to record it for you, because that would just be rude to my audience. So instead, I'm gonna teach you how to make some anabolic puppy chow, because I love puppy chow, but it's full of shit, so you can't really eat it all the time, especially when you're dieting down. So I'm gonna teach you how to make some anabolic ass puppy chow that tastes unreal. And so this is all the ingredients you need. You need rice squares, rice chex, whatever. You need some powdered peanut butter or regular peanut butter. I'm using this to save calories, up to you. You're gonna need milk chocolate chips. I got the stevia sweetened ones to decrease calories, of course. And then a chocolate based whey protein. Or just any protein. I'm using this chocolate PB Puff flavored one from Black Magic because I love the taste of it. And it goes with the theme, chocolate peanut butter, you can't beat it. I normally don't really like to taste protein powder, but this one tastes amazing. I'll link it below if you want to get the same one as me. If not,
use a chocolate-based one. This is the best one, in my opinion, to use for taste. But if not, use a chocolate-based protein and you'll be fine. So, this is what we're going to do. First thing, and we're also going to need 2 grams of sugar-free sweetener. Or whatever, like a Splenda sweetener thing. Or 1 packet. I use 1 packet. I have the packets. But you can, if you have the big ass bag of it, 2 grams. First things first. Also, I'm looking a tad bloated right now. I had a huge dinner. Not sitting well with me, but you know. We're doing this dessert for the people. So stay tuned. Okay, we got, so what we're gonna need is 2 servings of this. 2 servings of this. And 1 serving of the rice squares. So first I'm gonna weigh out the chocolate chips. 28 grams. Two servings. Oh, and if you didn't see, we got a food scale right there. If you don't have a food scale, I don't know what to tell you. All right, if you don't have a food scale, I don't know what to tell you. I'm using it to make sure I have the accurate measurements for everything. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take these chocolate chips and I'm gonna put them in this little pan that's been warming up on the stovetop. You can do it in the microwave, but I prefer not to nuke my food. So I'm doing it on the stove. Radiation ain't cool, chief. Chocolate going right on there. And it's gonna melt. I'm gonna turn that on low, let it melt. I need the bowl. What I'm going to do now is place 2 servings of this PB2 in this bowl, which is 24 grams. 24. I spilled a tad bit on the food scale, which is unfortunate, but it is what it is. Whatever. That's fine. 24 grams. Then I'm gonna take some water. Or you can do almond milk too. Or regular milk if you're feeling like a freak. I'm just gonna do regular water. Pour it in this PB2. Now, it depends on the consistency that you like. Obviously, you wanna aim for like a peanut buttery consistency. I find that when using the PB2, a little bit on the waterier side is better. So I'm gonna mix this up and show you what it looks like when I like it. All right, so check this out. This is the consistency I like. Slightly more runny. You see how it like slips and slides a little bit? Slightly more runny than peanut butter, because I feel like it sticks to the rice squares a little bit better. So now, perfect timing. Our chocolate has been melted up real good. And I'm gonna, it's all going in the same spot. So I'm just gonna take the same spoon and slide the chocolate into there. Oh yeah. And stir that all up together to form a glorious concoction. If you can smell these smells right now, I can't even describe to you what you'd be doing to me if you could smell these smells. Oh yeah. Okay, so once all the chocolate is stirred into the peanut butter and you get like a chocolatey peanut butter concoction, what you're gonna do is weigh out 1 serving of the protein that you're gonna be putting on the rice checks. So 1 serving of this protein is 39 grams. The reason I know, literally smells so good. Oh my gosh, I can't even. Oh. 39 grams. Money. What a money shot. It's like a heaping scoop. for whatever reason. All right, so protein's in here. The literal ambrosia of the gods is in here. And our flavor pack, our stevia sweetener pack. Okay. Oh my gosh, chest ration coming at you. I didn't mean to scare you guys like that. All right, guys, I don't know where this cut off at. The camera died in the middle of my elaborate speech about puppy chow and health. So yeah, that sucks. I finished it off though, and it's been chilling for 30 minutes while the pack of the batteries has been charging. So basically what I did was I weighed out one serving of the Rice Chex into this Tupperware. And then I put the warm mixture of peanut butter and chocolate that we created over the top and stirred it until it was all over the Rice Chex. Then I poured the protein powder on top and stirred it till it was coated in all of it. And then I put the stevia sweetener to act as like powdered sugar on top. And this is what we're left with. Look at that creation. And everything is totally coated. Everything's completely coated in that goodness. And it smells phenomenal. I'll give you a quick taste test. Look at that. Literally incredible. I'm gonna put the macros right here. You can literally eat this every night. That's how good it is. Amazing macro-friendly snack. And yeah, give it a shot. If you do, let me know. Tag me in it or something. Tag me in it or like text message me and say, hey, Luke, you're fucking genius. And I'm gonna be like, dude, I know. Just kidding. I didn't come up with the recipe by myself. I found it on like the Fit or the Flexible Dieting Lifestyle or Remington James maybe. I forget. I've watched both of them for diet stuff. So check them out. Their channels are dope. But I got that idea from them. This is how I make it. It's amazing. Thank you so much for watching the video. I love you guys so much for all the support. It's literally been awesome. Looking forward to making some more sweet content. I'm gonna get better at editing, getting better at everything. So literally the encouragement's been awesome. I'm loving doing this. If you haven't already, like the video and subscribe to the channel. It'll mean the world to me. I'm gonna post a video every Friday. I might up the ante a little bit, start posting more videos, start hammering out a little bit more. Might start, you know, doing some more creative stuff. But if you like the video, that's awesome. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Peace out, guys. Much love.